Now, having made this trouser too tight on the waist area to actually pull it up, I'm having to insert a zip in this. To insert the zip, I've opened up, it was an open side trouser anyway, so what we'd basically done was opened up the side seams. Now I've double stitched it at the beginning, and this is a very, very basic, easy type of zip to put in. What I suggest you do is you can actually double fold the edges if you wanted, just to stop the fraying. Now I'm going to insert the zip just a little bit lower than because I'm going to fold over the belt area in this, so about 2 inches below the turning, I'm just going to turn the fabric side over, keeping it aligned so that, I mean, this zip is not going to be visible, it's going to be covered by the dress, obviously. And it's just a straightforward turning up to the point of where you're going to finish attaching this. Turn on the spot and seam across, and this is just like a square off type of zip attachment. I obviously want to keep it as simple as possible. It's a short zip which is attached on the inside leg of the trouser, on the outer side leg of the trouser, on the left hand, right hand side, I think this one is. Yeah, this is attached on the right hand side. Now, the trouser that I'm going to do is I'm going to pleat this and just belt it at the back, elasticate it at the back. So, to pleat it at the front, I'm going to take equal amount of fabric on both sides and just, now the type of pleats that we're going to do are straightforward box pleats, which are, you know, we're taking a fabric, we're not going to curve this out or anything, it's going to be a straight line up about 2 inches, 4 inches, you know, about 3 inches. We're going to be making a turning off about 1.5, and the same, exact same on the other side. It's a half an inch pleat, 1 inch of fabric that's been pinched and seamed down halfway. So what that has done is just marginally tightened it at the front, and the back I'm going to elasticate. The elastic we're going to use is a half an inch wide elastic. We're going to cut this about 10 inches. That piece of elastic I'm going to attach on the inside of the back opening seam. And also on the inside of where I have attached the zip. So this is just a quick solution to a problem where the trouser is too tight to pull up on the waist area, and what we are doing with this is quickly and sort of effortlessly just elasticating the front or the back of the trouser. And the front, we are just straight belting it. So attach, trapping the elastic on the inside, I'm just seaming this just below the elastic, making sure that the elastic is not stitched. And I will come back and double stitch this once I have done the initial stitching. But now, once it becomes a little bit hardened and you have less elastic left to stitch on just below, just pull on the elastic so that it gives you a little bit more room to sew. point of where I have elasticated it to the front. I'm going to just straight belt, self-belt that area without any stiffener or anything. I'm not using any stiffener or anything with this. Now this wasn't planned to be made like this. This is just one of those things that's happened, and we're sort of in that situation where we need a solution to a problem. Now there is always a solution if you are willing to put the effort into it. So that's the back of the trouser and that's the front of the trouser. So basically what you have is take away all the threads and you have a fairly neat and easy solution to a problem which was otherwise difficult to actually pull up. And to be honest, I think my customer would actually prefer this. So it's more of a fitted look of a trouser rather than actually the whole loose trouser. And it's been elasticated at the back, and the front I have pleated and just really hurriedly finished this off.